Oh my God, look who I am talking to, the one and only Conan Gray. Hi, Conan.
Hi.
Okay, let's start off with your Instagram and Twitter bio. Your social media bio is very simple. It's just one word, overthinking. Are you that big of an overthinker, Conan?
Absolutely. I genuinely think that songwriters are just professional overthinkers. Mm-hmm. All I do all day long is think about everything that's ever happened to me at all times. You know, like something as little as someone like looking at me at a supermarket, I can just think about that for an entire day and write a song about it. But I do. I wish I could turn it off, but I can't.
What was the last thing you overthought about?
Ooh, this interview, for sure.
I hope I didn't give you a stare that made you overthink, because my stare was a good one. It's a positive one, Conan, I swear. No lie.
I'm okay with overthinking. I enjoy it. It's my natural state.
It probably does help you in your songwriting as well, maybe, because you've got more things to think about, more things to write about eventually. And you've done your YouTube videos, your vlog, since you were so small. I saw your videos. I was like, Fetus Conan, oh my God. You know, do you ever go through your old videos?
No, I do not. I'm so embarrassed. When I was like literally 14, I don't know who allowed me to be on the internet when I was 14, but there I was making videos about middle school. I don't know why. I think it's funny. I really did grow up on the internet. I've been making YouTube videos since I was like 9 years old. Sometimes, you know, like my friends will send me something. They're like, "Ah, you're so dumb." I'm like, "Yeah, I know. I was really dumb. I regret everything." But there it is. And I just have to deal with it.
What do you feel about your old videos? Do you cringe if you ever watch them? Or you find yourself cute?
No, ew, the deepest cringe. Like when I see them, I want to suck my body into my neck and disappear. I hate it so much. It's so embarrassing. It's the worst. I hate that people can watch those videos.
That's the thing, and people are still watching it. It's millions of views, and people are constantly commenting, "Oh my God, baby Conan. Oh my God, 14-year-old Conan." And yet you're like, "Stay away from me. I don't want to look at this video. I want to buy a panic for my
account." I would like to see how people would feel if videos of them when they were 12 were being watched by 100,000 people. They'd be embarrassed too.
I think I heard in an interview, you said that you actually wrote songs almost every day since you were 12. Almost, is it every day or is it almost every day?
Basically every day. Sometimes I'll write like two or three songs in a day, and then sometimes I just won't write for a day. But the second I wrote my first song, it was a feeling that I had been waiting to find for so long. And I truly wonder if I'll ever fall in love with anyone or anything more than I've fallen in love with songwriting. I think also a form of love that people don't talk about, but I write a lot about, is platonic love. You know, I write about my friend, how much I love him so much. And I feel like there's so many different forms of love. And I think that songwriting is the love of my life. That's why I write so much.
You hardly do any collaborations, right? I've been going through your music. You've never done a collaboration before. But if you were to do a collaboration anytime soon with a K-pop artist, who would it be and why?
I think right now, it'd probably be V from BTS.
Wow.
I love him so much. And he's so talented. I just think it'd be so much fun. I think we'd write such a beautiful song together.
And he even loves your music. That's the best part.
I mean, that's just like the ultimate compliment. It's just so wild. It's just very, very sweet. And I'm so flattered.
And your song Heather is heavily played right here in Malaysia, especially on my chart show. So let's talk about it. You know, do you expect it to be this big and this positively received?
No, not at all. It was a huge surprise to me. I think, you know, when I was making the album, I had my favorite songs, and I had songs that I guess I kind of thought that maybe people would like more than others. I had no idea that it would be Heather that got so much attention, and it makes me really happy because Heather's my favorite song off the album. I've been saying that since the album came out, and I've been saying that since before the album came out, you know, tweeting and being like, "Oh, I can't wait for you guys to hear Heather," because it's just a feeling that I've wanted to get into a song for so long. You know, that feeling of like, you'll never be the first choice, and there's always going to be that person who's prettier and nicer and sweeter and all those things and more beautiful than you. It's like something that I've always felt. You know, I've never had someone that I've liked like me back before. So it just makes me really happy that people relate to that feeling, because I also was really embarrassed that I was like so jealous of the person that I wrote the song about. And it was a huge surprise to me. I had no idea. And it's just, it makes me feel so grateful.
What else can we expect from Conan Gray this year?
I think that mostly I'm just working on music and hopefully just a few few little things here and there. I'm not gonna say anything, but tell me things. People, there's things. You'll see them.
Thank you so much, Conan. I had such a fun chat with you. And please, hopefully, that once everything dials down, you get to see Conan Gray right here in Malaysia. Please, hopefully, that time soon.
I would love that. Thank you so much for having me.